Welcome back. We're now playing in the weekly teaching ladder for Shogi. The idea is we get to play a higher rated opponent and a lower rated opponent and review the game afterward. So, this time I get to play as the first player. The opponent is already opening with something with an aggressive opening. I'm not sure how best to counter that, actually. Let's apply something we wanted to try last game but never had the time to do. Okay, so the opponent opens this diagonal as well. Intriguing. Well, there are several other things I'd like to try. This is something I've always been a bit curious about. We're gonna learn Shogi the hard way. Welcome. So yeah, this will be good fun. Obviously I'm protecting against a bishop drop that would hit both of these pawns simultaneously. And we're just going to take a second and castle my king. Okay. Tactics may be possible here already. Right in the opening. But that's okay. We don't need to worry about every little tactic. What's important is that our king is defended. So they've blocked their bishop. I'm still not totally sure which file I want my rook to use. Okay, this ice. Interesting. Okay, we're gonna prepare a right fourth file rook attack. And it's gonna be fun. So, yeah, this is what they were trying to stop me from doing, and I'm gonna do it anyway. Yeah, so they're building the fortress with one little detail a bit different. And so that detail is that this bishop is like trapped in the corner. So I've got time to develop all of my pieces here. However, I want to do that. I don't know the absolute truth of this position, but feels like there's something going on here. I'm curious how they're going to finish this. So we'll make way for my silver to join this attack right in front of their king. Yes, I did just block my bishop, but I don't anticipate things will stay that way for long. So. All right. Forward we march. Ever forward, ever onward, ever upward, etc. Let's unblock my bishop. So our opponent has condensed all of their pieces in this corner of the board. So we'll just take the rest of the board, and see how it goes. Let me rebalance the desktop audio so the piece snapping isn't so thunderous. There we go. But yeah, this should be fun. They might try to bring the rook up and hit the bishop's head. But I might try to use my rook on that file instead. I'm really not sure where this rook belongs, but I'm not sure what they're doing either. We have both slowed down. I'm going to slow down a bit too. In terms of just taking a little more time to think about the moves. I did start a bit slow at first and picked up the pace, and now we're slowing down to think a bit more again. So this is where the king is. If I push an exchange and stuff, I'll be out a pawn there, but able to use the pawn elsewhere. Oh, actually, I could play opposing rook here. They could counter, and I could take this with check. So maybe that's the big idea here. Also, I could push this first and then bring the rook over. That looks interesting. Oh, but then, like, they move, duck the king back. Pawn up, pawn takes, rook over, king back. Oh, but then I take the pawn. Yeah, it's fine. Interesting. Yeah. This looks like a decent time for an attack. All of their pieces are condensed this way. If the king were back here, this bishop would not be able to attack the king with check. But, yeah. That's. Looks like I just win the pawn. Now they'll try to attack down this file instead, and that's fine. Oh, wait. Rook over, bishop takes, king back. I'm missing a move. I miscounted that somehow. Somehow I counted that my rook would be here and my bishop would be there already. That's not the current situation. It's not at all fatal, but just disappointing. Oh wow. An invitation, you say? Don't mind if I do. Don't mind if I do. All right, well, this file is now mine. And suddenly, opening theory doesn't matter so much anymore. Whether it's opposing rook or fourth file rook or right fourth file rook or any of that, kind of pales in comparison to, like, my gold is hanging. Their king's a little bit exposed. They have a pretty strong castle shape, but the bishop's stuck in the corner. So I'm effectively up a bishop, at least for this instant. I could take a pawn, they could take my pawn. I could do bishop takes pawn. They could take back here. Truly, there are possibilities in this position. Oh, if I silver takes, gets my silver trapped. So maybe I don't want to do that. But yeah, bishop takes looks totally fine and reasonable here. And, oh, I was going to say, okay, yeah, if they pursue my bishop, I could just take the knight. So they don't pursue my bishop. That's fine. Let's go promote my rook. So I am down 15 seconds, but seemingly my position is pretty good. So the weakest point in my position is either my hanging rook or my hanging gold general. But I think I'll survive. I guess my current plan is to promote and then chase the rook and take the knight and all this fun stuff. I could retreat the bishop, or I could take here as I was suggesting. They take, I take. It's kind of spooky. There's no need for such spookiness, is there? Yeah, let's just retreat. That's fine. Okay, they take my pawn. Let's take here and promote. And if they push here, I can bring up my gold, defending my generals, and also protecting against this promotion. So let's do that. And that blocks their rook. Okay, I just walked square into that. That's pretty cool. Kudos to them for paying attention in this position. Better than I did. All right, so I mean, I've been obsessed with this Tokien attacking the rook idea, and I guess now I really get to test it out. Yeah. All right. Let's do it. Don't try this at home. But yeah, their idea is they could bring the rook up out of my attack, and I'm just giving some kind of material here somehow, because I didn't calculate things properly. Well, if the rook comes up, I could drop a pawn to hit it. That's a happy coincidence. If the rook goes up one square, I guess, yeah, I still have tactics. So many happy coincidences. Such luck. But even if I were to lose the silver general here, that would hardly be an issue. Yeah, it'd be discouraging, but even if like somehow their rook promoted onto my back rank, I still have a castle. I still have a bishop. My rook is looking to promote pretty soon here. So, yeah, even if the worst happened, I'd still be doing okay. But the worst isn't happening here. All right, so we do this exchange, and now their rook is trapped-ish. So they're looking to promote here. I want to continue playing aggressively, because aggression's kind of fun. But if I were to drop a gold, if this rook, the rook would have to drop back here if it's trying to escape capture. But then I could promote my rook, but then they could block this line. Oh, interesting. I could keep peeling away the castle. That's kind of fun. Sure. Let's fight back against the rook this way. Yeah, taking the knight and dropping a gold back here and stuff looks interesting, but this trapping the rook directly looks a bit promising. Yes, I foresee the rook drops back, and maybe I promote here, or maybe I take the knight, I'm not sure. They block this line or move the king away, and then I could drop a pawn here. And we start exchanging, and this wall still cuts the king out of the corner. Or do I drop the pawn first? And we exchange, and somehow some tactic makes this epic for me. Not sure what I would do with a silver general. And also, gold general probably helps their defense considerably. But who knows? For more beginner-like players, I guess the general advice here is be very careful in building your castle. I know in Shogi you're always having to balance attacking and defending, and in this case, I built a really strong castle, and the opponent started an attack, and I was able to start a counterattack. Okay. Let's promote this here. This threatens to take there. Yeah. All right, the king walks forward. That's good fun. I could trap the rook. Or I could take here. I think the rook trap exchange. Oh, wait. If I trap the rook and then I move the tokien over, yeah, that's decisive. That's pawn power. Yeah. How unfortunate. What attracted me to trying to do something very forceful here is that nothing's defending this gold general other than the king. So several times I hesitated with my attack and decided to wait and see what my opponent is doing first. And my opponent did an attack, and I had a choice between do I defend or do I counterattack? And at least at one point here I counterattacked, and that's why we're here today. Yeah, so kind of like Go, there's always a bit of give and take. Yeah. My rook went to the left, and then my rook went to the right, and then it went back left again. Just based on where I thought the opportunities were in those positions. It's not like this is some crazy opening variation. Okay, we threaten checkmate next move with the rook drop. Also threatening to take the silver or take the knight or take the gold, maybe. Yeah, this is difficult. A silver retreat would defend the rook drop. That's true. Is it a perfect defense? Not quite. Right. So, how do you win a one game? Like, I could take the silver if I thought that would help me checkmate. I could drop the rook and take here at the pawn and then take the gold and threaten the bishop. That doesn't seem constructive. Yeah, so I need another piece in this attack. Not sure which piece. It's so tempting to snap the silver, but it'll be there. Is a silver what I need? Maybe. There's a good chance it might be what I need. Because I could drop it back here. And then this gold, which is protecting this silver, doesn't have many places it can go. Feel like I'm still missing something, though. Like, I could pursue this with my promoted pawn. Oh, wait, silver drop. Oh, the gold can retreat, though. So, like, this is not instantly decisive. The silver drop is not perfect either. Searching for mate. It's so hard to checkmate in this game. There's so many ways to evade checkmate. Taking the knight's not bad. And then the knight drops here. And a silver drop and a rook drop. Yeah, okay. That looks right. So they're inclined to defend something on the back rank somehow. Oh, this does. I missed that. That's frustrating. I missed that. It feels like that's. In retrospect, that looks obvious. But okay. What now? They're gonna promote, they move the silver and then be able to move this bishop. Which is not what I was looking forward to here. Well, this is going to take a while to checkmate, but that's my fault. Like, if I pursued the silver with this token earlier. Oh, okay, now they've blocked in the bishop. So now that's a cell that they're not going to escape from. Yeah, it'd be great to have a mate, but this is more than adequate. I'm wanting the pawn to serve so many roles here. Just feels like I need just one more and then one more and then one more piece. Somehow I never quite have enough. All right. Let's break things open here. Right, this gives the gold somewhere to retreat to. So we're trying to unplug this diagonal here. I don't see anywhere. Maybe potentially a knight could have dropped here instead. But I mean, worst comes to worst, we waste two mo knights moving the knight, waste two moves advancing this knight. But that's not happening. I'd be careful about this pawn push unless I've missed something. Like, I'm threatening to take this gold and then take this gold. There's not a lot of subtlety to that. Oh, they're pursuing my bishop. Interesting. I hadn't considered that. All right, we're just gonna keep my king safe. If they want my bishop that much, they can have it. yeah, we're gonna keep the castle intact and continue attacking. So eventually, once things move, then we're just going to drop the silver here and everything collapses. This attack can no longer be deterred at all. It sucks having to block the rook for a turn, but you gotta do what you gotta do. Okay. I'm confused. They're gonna block this with a pawn, right? The pawn's not gonna go back. Well, a pawn back here wouldn't do anything anyway.
30秒.
Just in case.
これより秒
So,
読みに入ります。
there's a lot. I could advance the silver up one. Could just take the bishop. I could also reinforce the silver. Well, that's interesting. That's kind of fun. If I bring the bishop up here,
30秒.
that doesn't do anything. Maybe it does. I'm curious. It's not what I expected. Jeez. I have a silver in hand.
30秒.
I'm not confident that's a mate. That looks like mate. That looks a lot like mate. I think they have to block. Oh, I'm sorry. This clearly is mate without, like, the stupid way I'm pursuing it. I just move the token up this way. No need for a bishop drop here. Yeah.
30秒.
I don't need to do things the hard way. Somehow I was thinking like bishop
40秒.
drop and then other stuff, but now this is just really direct. That'll do it. Thanks for the game. That was exciting, wasn't it? All right. So it looks like we'll be doing post-game analysis using Discord as we did with the last game. Again, this is all experimental, so if there's an echo or something, I apologize to listeners, etc. We'll see what we can do to make things work out well. Let's initiate a voice call if I can figure out how to do it. Let's see. This is the opponent name. Hello. Are we able to do a voice call with them? Yeah, let's give it a shot. All right, cool. Calling. And yeah, they're hopping into Discord. See how this goes. Oh, I suppose also on Twitch I can take us out of emails only mode. Right, let's see. What are they saying here? Oh, you're in play together. Okay, I'll see if I can find them there. Play together, I guess, is a channel on Chogi Harbor's Discord server. This is more and more experimental as we go. Hello.
How's it going?
Hey, welcome.
Hello. What's up?
Sorry, on my end, you're kind of quiet.
I talk kind of quietly. I don't know if you can
Oh.
turn me up,
Okay, I'll double my speaker volume or something so I can hear you.
you should be able to. I don't know if you use Discord a lot, but you should be able to like click on my name and just turn up the
Oh, okay,
my
cool.
sound to
Let
like
me.
150 or whatever.
Nice. Well, you're coming through clearer now. Yeah.
Okay, cool. Maybe my
Cool.
mic just needed to adjust or something.
Oh, yeah, that could be. Anyhow, welcome.
Thank you. Good game.
It's exciting.
Yeah, I saw the mate at the end, but I was like, oh, I'll just play it out.
Yeah, it's too beautiful. Sometimes you just have to let it happen.
It was a solid, the Taku, the bishop sack, rook, dragon sack mate. It looked cool. I was like, let's play
Yeah,
it.
and I was sitting there calculating it the whole time, and I hear the counting each knee. I'm like, is this right? Is this right? Oh, yeah, there it is.
I feel like I'm actually curious if I didn't take the bishop, would it still be disaster? I kind of feel like yes, but
Yeah, I was thinking you had to block this. It looks like I
I
have an attack that's doing pretty well, but
could
yeah,
do
I think
this
you.
maybe.
Yeah, I'm curious. What can I do about this?
I think you
So.
might, if you capture the gold now, don't you still have a mating
Oh.
sequence?
Actually, yeah,
Oh, yeah, you
you're
probably didn't
spot
even
on.
need the token.
Yeah, gold
Because
star.
then,
Yeah.
and now it's over.
Yeah.
Or, no, okay. Is
What?
it? I think it is.
I'll let you work it out. So which check do we do next
Yeah, you
here?
could do gold or so. You could do the silver, it wouldn't really matter, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then you can drop the gold next move.
Yeah.
So yeah, it doesn't matter.
I could do something fancy. Oh wait, that's not mate. I have to use the
No.
this.
Careful.
Don't want to mess it up.
Don't get too fancy. Yeah. Okay, so that wouldn't have worked if I just
Yeah, you might have
tried to
to add a
run away.
piece or yeah, running away. Yeah. The checkmates were
Jeez.
never my strong suit. Huh.
Think this is still losing.
Yeah. I think my attack's doing okay. I don't know if it's mate or not, but yeah.
You could move the Tolkien to 4-1.
Yeah, to let's see. So one thing I was trying to do is avoid getting my rooks blocked, even though my Tolkien does block my rook right now.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, if this were Shogi Wars, I would just drop this back without even thinking, and I'd be like, well, okay, there's going to be a checkmate here eventually after I
At
take
some point,
this. But yeah, in a serious game, I'd look for a checkmate. Not sure if I'd find one here or not, but yeah.
and you could probably just take the gold, because
Oh,
then,
yeah. Oh, actually, yeah, because I have a bishop supporting this too. Yeah, that makes
yeah,
sense.
anything I block with, you can just capture. I could do this maybe, but I think this just delays. You can actually just pull the, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. I wrote down actually the moves that I felt like I was not sure about. I mean, so even from the get-go, I think fucking whoever I was talking about, also, I don't know if you're streaming right now. Sorry if
Oh,
I forget
yeah,
any
I
of
sometimes
this.
use coarse language. That's okay.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
So, people keep telling me the Yagura is bad, but it's like the only castle I know, or it's bad against ranging rook, but I don't actually know how to do like the Mino castle or the other ones, so I
Oh.
always just kind of default to the Yagura. And someone
Sure.
suggested like this castle where I have, and then move the gold up,
Yeah.
like here. But I don't actually know what to do with this castle, so I don't think it's good.
Oh, okay, that's fair. Yeah. I
Because the other
largely
thing
play.
is,
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah.
yeah, the other thing is now I've blocked in my bishop basically. Like I have nowhere to
Yeah.
put my king. So yeah, just felt bad, and I was feeling it for most of the game.
Yeah, this got really complicated. So, yeah, that fortress, the Agra, is something that I've not played very much. I don't know a whole lot about. I do know that,
It's,
like, oh, go ahead. Yeah.
yeah, from what I've heard about it now, I mean, it was just sort of the first one I learned because I read that it goes well with static rook or ranging rook. And I always play static rook because so far my strategy has been get good with one opening and then expand my repertoire later.
Sure.
And so the Yagura, from what I've read, is really good at defending attacks from the front. So it's great if you're playing static rook because you can't really get it. You'll have trouble pushing down the pawns
Yeah.
because I have generals here. But it's not great on the side because there's lots of places for you to just like drop pieces in. Also, I don't really know how to do the annotation.
Yes,
So.
you're right. It does kind of give up a little space toward your back rows in exchange for having a really solid castle and hopefully a strong attack with the rook too. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, like, this is my usual. I don't know, I'll just wait for you. It takes a while to get here, but
Yeah. Nice.
yeah, so that's the completed Yagura, or the gold Yagura, I guess.
Yes.
And then
Yeah.
I could I could continue on, I think, up to here.
Awesome. Yeah.
That's generally my been my goal, and usually what I do in Shogi Wars because it works pretty well, and most people play Static Rook.
Oh, that's awesome. Yeah. Yeah, and men,
But
yeah.
obviously,
You're right.
go ahead. Okay.
Yeah, you're right. Many players do play Static Rook against Static Rook, and you get a very exciting game that way.
Yeah. But I need to figure out a way to deal with ranging rook that I can actually get comfortable with.
Sure. Yeah, Shogi Harper has opined that there's like two kinds of shogi. There's like vertical shogi where you attacking like this and I attacking like that. And then there's a horizontal sort of shogi where we're both kind of attacking here, but then our kings are like susceptible to attack from this kind of way.
Yeah. I'm still working my way through her tips for beginners series, but I did see that one.
Yeah, there's a lot to absorb. I liked years ago she made this series Road to Shodan, which I thought was really
Oh.
interesting too. She like took viewer games and get to see like how beginners and intermediate players play and what advice they have for them too.
That's
Sometimes
cool.
seeing the advice in context helps out a lot. Yeah.
Yeah, cool. Were there specific moves or positions that you were thinking of? Or because I had like three or four moves I wanted to look at, and then just
Oh.
whatever you wanted to talk about would be cool.
Well, so I don't know necessarily, like I found it interesting that my rook kept dancing left and right. That like
I
I
find it
couldn't
really annoying.
Yeah.
It's like, oh shit.
I like,
I thought
well,
he was
okay,
gonna
well he
play ranging
defended
rook,
this
and then
well
he
and he
made it
defended that
static.
well. So what am I gonna do?
Yeah. I felt like this was a bad move for me.
Yeah, I thought it was, and so I pounced on it. Whether it is or not, I thought it was. I could be wrong, though.
Well, because
Yeah.
yeah, because after this, I actually thought you were just gonna capture the pawn
Oh, yeah.
right away. And then, I mean, I guess I could do that, but you can just defend.
Yeah.
Or actually,
And this kind of transposes a bit to, yeah, initially somehow I thought I'd get this position and it would be my turn, and that's not how that worked out.
yeah. How did this go? Like that. Yeah, and then here I was like, okay, well that pawn's dead. There's nothing I can do
Oh,
to
well, it looks
get.
scary. What if it happens if you try to defend it, though?
What would I even defend it with?
I
The
guess
rook.
maybe the rook, right? Putting the rook
And
back on the
then.
nice open file, I think. And so, yeah, there is a tactical shot. And I was thinking, well, okay, I do this, and then it's my move again, and I can sack this, but it's not my turn.
Well, even without it being your turn,
Yeah.
I mean, I guess I could do here to
Yeah,
close up the
yeah.
file. Yeah.
Yeah, I think this puts up one heck of a fight.
Yeah, that still makes me really uncomfortable, though.
Well, yeah, you're playing the world's strongest castle, and I'm trying to like break through before that happens. Because once you build
Yeah.
it, I'm in trouble.
Yeah, see, I was way too slow building my castle and then
Yeah.
kind of gave up halfway through. Is this though an okay position for me though?
I think
Because what would you
so.
do from here on
So,
that?
this is it's actually complicated. I've played this side or your side of this position, except like left and right flipped or something like that.
Sure.
And yeah, having the rook behind a rapidly advancing pawn that's difficult to block is kind of puts in a challenge on the opponent. Yeah, you don't have a pawn in hand, but in this case, it I think, like, if I run away, I think you have time to, like, complete your castle and then do whatever kind of attack you want to do here.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah,
What
I'm.
if you sack the bishop though? Because
Oh,
that
what
was
if.
kind of what I thought was coming.
Oh, if I
Is
sack
if you
this
just
here. Oh, that's kind of cool. Let's see. Yeah, that keeps the castle intact. I
I
need
mean,
a.
now my ping's out in the middle of the board.
Yeah, so it all comes down to, I guess, whether or not this is decisive, but I don't think this works. I think I'm a piece short on this attack.
I capture
Because, like,
that.
yeah, maybe I've got something here, but I don't really believe it.
I don't think so.
I just run out of pieces, I think.
Well,
It's.
not like right away, I guess, but it's going to
Oh, I
take me a
see.
while to get all the way back to the castle.
Yeah.
My thought, I don't know, maybe something like advancing here.
Oh, that's kind of cool. Yeah, that makes more sense, actually. Yeah. I like having materials, so I'm having a hard time about this, but
Or I guess
yeah,
leave an
that looks
achievement.
fine. Or you might not even need to take the pawn necessarily. You might be able to just attack the lance and this here.
Oh, that's true too. Right, so maybe instead of advancing the pawn,
Yeah.
you move here instead.
Yeah,
So I
that's
don't really
pretty
see a
cool.
good spot for my bishop.
Yeah. Yeah, this, I'm a bit. I really, being that I'm a chess player first and a shogi player second, I like hanging on to big material, but that tends to be my downfall
Yeah.
too.
I also started with chess, but I noticed that you, I don't know, I felt like you were playing like a chess player, if that makes sense.
Yeah, it's pretty tactical stuff. Yeah, viewers chiming in that also, like, what about, like, if we were to, like, bring the rooks and I were to offer a rook exchange or something like that.
Oh, yeah.
In this case, I think
This
the
seems
rook.
so much worse for me, actually. Like,
Oh, this? Huh.
this seems horrible for me. I have no generals.
Well, I think one good thing about this, though, is, like, you're. Generals are very connected, defending each other here.
There, the wrong side of the king for a rook trap.
Yeah.
I mean, after this, like,
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, you're right. That's check, isn't it? Shoot.
yeah.
If that weren't check, then yeah, I would prefer your side of this. But actually, I think the king has to go back here in this case so I don't get another check.
Oh yeah.
But.
This
Huh.
is, yeah, this is
Oh, this is
disastrous.
ugly. Actually, I guess I am threatening to take this with check if I don't have my rook hanging first, but yeah.
Yeah.
In this case, the rook's actually defending it, but so I think I'd need to
Oh yeah.
actually, yeah, if the king dropped vertically back, I would have this. I missed this. So what's the conclusion on
Oh
this?
wait, no. Actually, go forward with that. The
Oh,
rook exchange
okay.
is terrible for me. So yeah, here. So let's say I drop there and you drop there. And I do something like that. I'd
So this
probably go
is.
straight back actually, because of because to try and stay close to my generals. You
Yeah.
promote, I do literally anything, and then that's check, and
Yeah.
I lose the rook.
Right. Yeah, so I missed this. So this actually would be a material win for me here.
And also, again, all my, how do I notate? Do I
Well,
check
yeah,
it?
the spookiest bit
Oh,
about it
no.
actually is that taking the rook might not be the right move. that this might be more decisive.
Oh, yeah. That's, I think that's
Which
me,
is,
isn't
that's crazy.
it?
I didn't think that would happen here.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I guess I missed that shot. Normally, I'd like your rook drop here, except this rook drop, like you pointed out, is so scary. It's a check there. So yeah,
Yeah, you
dropping
just
in
need to
your.
drop it back.
Well, if you've played Shogi
No, we're
Wars
back
bef
to the same.
well, if you played Shogi Wars before, you know it's useful to have the rook in the opposing camp.
Yes, yeah.
So yeah, I
I know
get.
that's one of the usually
Yeah, I get this desire to. Yeah.
if
Yeah, you could spend multiple minutes attacking your opponent and they have to constantly defend against every little thing you throw at them.
you're gonna lose.
But
So yeah.
this might be a lucky pawn drop that maybe holds in this particular circumstance. I don't know. I really like this rook drop idea because it's like attacking the king and the bishop and the knight and the gold and the lance and like
Right.
everything's all kind of vulnerable, whereas you have a really nice castle, although the king's in the wrong side of it,
Yeah,
but
no, it's yeah, everything over here.
my entire shape is extremely unsound here because I attacked early, so it's double-edged.
I think I just closed the game somehow. Dude, I don't understand. I need to figure out the UI for this.
Oh yeah, there's like an eraser button toward the top of the screen, like next to the hat button. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. I'll figure it out eventually.
That's yeah. But yeah, our viewer was chiming in. Why was I suggesting the bishop takes instead of offering the rook exchange? And they're saying like I have time to fix my bishop position and try to recover from this, but like. The reason I would take with the bishop and avoid the rook exchange is because I think there's so many places you could drop a rook and it could be near fatal for me here. So I might want to.
Maybe. I think you're still pretty well defended. You've got most of the Mino going on.
I'll be
Like,
able to complete that in a move.
yeah.
Yeah. And that is a good. Yeah.
Yeah, you're totally fine from threats over here. It's just
Yeah. Yeah, so if I have that one move, and I guess I do, then yeah, I do get to complete my castle, and yeah, I guess you'll get some pieces, and it'll be a difficult for you to castle. I guess this is good.
Yeah, so this was probably the best move here. I decided to try and be aggro because that's my instinct is to just get aggressive.
Oh, sure. Yeah. Let's see.
Was there other stuff you wanted to look at? Here or
I'm thinking. Well, the I guess what was it, King 4-2 or something? When did that happen?
this
Somehow
was like
this.
way at the beginning. This is a well, because I was trying to do a castle I don't really know. Yeah,
Oh,
it's
I
like
see.
incredible.
Okay. Yeah, it's slowly dawning on me what might have jumbled here. I watched some videos by Muranaka, Seven Dan Professional. On YouTube, and he shows a variety of different strategies. Yeah, King 4-1, I guess, might be more harmonious with this. And I guess King 4-2 is like the Rapid Fortress or Rapid Yagra.
Yeah, I think that's what I was trying to do because someone suggested it, and I don't
Yeah.
know the Rapid Yagura at all. And
I think this mostly works if,
I guess
well, I again,
so.
I
You know
don't know
what?
everything about it, but I think the idea is that the king advances through this square here and then there, and the bishop ducks
Yeah.
back around, and this gold is back here the whole time or something, and it saves one move, but it's kind of risky.
I think you need to do maybe the king before the gold is the issue, is like go here first, and then
Yeah,
I need to
for that
block your
particular move
bishop or
order.
make an exchange,
Yeah.
and then I can get this up and move in.
Yeah. And again, I'm not really an expert on this. I don't play this a whole lot, but yeah, I think that's what you ran into. It's like, yeah, I think you're right about pointing out King 4-1.
Yeah, or I think if I was already here, I think what I could have done instead is just moved the bishop out of the way this way.
It's worth a try. I have seen opponents try to do this before. And so usually I'd either counter by with my rook or by bringing the gold up.
Yeah, which is fine for me, honestly, because I'm just trying to like get the king and the castle, and now the bishop's out of the way. So, but yeah. Anyhow, all right. I wanted to go back here. Let me know if you saw anything. I know kind of the next move I was wondering about.
Well, I mean, one thing you mentioned
I
is
was.
like having just to learn one opening, and the one opening being the static rook, right? But yeah, if you're curious about how to make the Mino, it's kind of like the shape I was making here, right? Where I just bring the silver up one square and bring the king around, and that's the Mino.
And then make
Or
this
bring the
pawn
king
anyway.
through and then the silver up afterward. Oh yeah, you're right. Actually, I played this pawn up super early.
See,
Earlier t
but this is with a ranging rook. This doesn't work in a static rook because my rook is there.
ah yeah so yeah
Yeah,
if
you tap
you're
along the
well
rook.
yeah
I don't know
there's
how to
right Mino
make
and then
it.
there's left Mino, so
Yeah,
you
I need to
can
figure out how to do left Mino.
yeah I think it's the same sh well I don't play static rook, but I think it would be a similar shape with silver up and the king just going to the square, but the somehow the bishop would have to move too.
It'd probably be I guess you would and you'd have to get the gold out of the way. I don't know. I'll have to look it up later.
But yeah, that is a possibility. But otherwise, the fortress, the Yagra, is extremely strong, but the move order does matter.
Yes. Well, and it's strong against static rook. It's not as
Oh,
strong.
that's
I might
right.
just keep playing the Yagura, to be honest, because I don't know. The players who are giving me this advice are like 3 Dan, 4 Dan, and I'm like, I'm not there yet. Yeah.
Yeah,
I do the same castle every time. It works well enough at my level.
it's kind of like a chess player learning the Sicilian defense, the dragon Sicilian or something, and they're like, yeah, it's excellent opening.
Dude, the Sicilian's great. Like, yeah, I'm sure there's situations where, like, d4,
Yeah.
where maybe isn't as powerful, but like it still works well enough.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a in fact when I've been playing chess for quite a few years and got a rating
Me
close
too.
to 2000, and around the time I hit 1800 or so, I just hit a brick wall because I was playing my king pawn the first move every game. And just opponents knew all these openings way better than I did, and I couldn't be bothered to study every variation there. So eventually I switched to playing queen pawn opening, and just that helped as I was able to play similar structures every game. And yeah, made it from like 1800 to almost 2000 just switching my
Nice.
opening.
Yeah, I've heard that the queen pawn is objectively better, but
Yeah, it's easier.
has a higher win rate. Yeah.
Yeah, I
I
visited
just like
near,
the clap with the king.
I visited, I think it was a Fedorowicz lecture at the Chicago Open. They were just doing a free lecture out in a side room off the main tournament.
Nice.
And he was explaining, yeah, just play this. You could play similar shapes. You'll never have a problem in your life doing this. I'm like, huh. That sounds way easier than what I've been trying to do. But
Yeah.
yeah, the fortress, it's a fantastic opening. I haven't studied it yet. But I think it's wonderful if you're playing tournaments. I don't know how easy it is for players, even at my level, to learn this the right way. And it seems like everyone books up on it.
Of Yagura.
Yeah.
I just looked at the shape. and then stuck to the opening principles of, like, if you open your silver, make sure you, or open your bishop, make sure your gold is next to it, etc. So I don't know, I'm probably doing it wrong, but it doesn't matter until you hit probably like one dan or one q or something. My it says in on q, I'm actually like probably fifth, maybe five or six.
Yeah, there's it's also funny, like when I started playing on the side, I think my first opening was Static Rook, and I tried that until I almost made it to 5Q or something. I was just having the hardest time playing Static Rook, and it seemed like everyone on this site knows it.
And also, I do feel like more people, at least that I've played with on 81 Dojo, do Ranging Rook instead of Static Rook, which is more of the Shogi Wars of maybe, but that could just be my when I'm playing is like
Oh, that's
happens to me.
cool. Yeah, you might be right.
Anyways. Back to the game. So I kind of just wanted to like push in. I also I didn't notice this move until a couple moves later.
Oh, that's fair.
I was like, whatever, the knight's dead. I might as well go for the silver or something like semi-substantial, and then I saw that. It's like, oh, okay.
No, I think what you played was just fine. It's possible maybe I could have taken the knight, but I was too scared of your attack to actually do it.
Oh,
And
nice, cool. Then
so,
my tactic worked.
yeah.
My intimidation check
I
passed.
think it's you had a legit attack here, and you have four generals all around your king, and it's like, I'm
Right.
not gonna checkmate that.
Yeah, see, once I got the, I figured I could get the gold out of the way and then pull the silver back at some point once I push the king up and then end up in my Yagura. But
And what I was thinking is, well, okay, I expect my opponent's going to spend some time shuffling their generals around, trying to get the king into the corner where it should be. And so while
yeah.
they're doing all that shuffling, I'm just going to start taking pieces.
Right, and I was like, I'll just leave the pieces because I need to get my king into safety. I tried pushing a little harder and being a little more
Now, this is
aggressive.
good. Like, it's super important to use the rook, I think. Yeah, I
I think it was just
miscalculated.
too slow. And what did you miscalculate?
Well, I thought, like, you would not be able to promote this at all. I thought I came up with, like, this perfect defense where it's a very one-sided thing and you didn't have any attack. And then you drop this pawn here, and I'm like, well, crap, I
Oh,
didn't
yeah.
see that.
Ah.
So this suddenly got really tactical because if the silver retreats, then you're able to promote here, and then I'm having to deal with this, and my bishop's hanging, knight's loose, and it's kind of a mess. Even though, yeah, your king's not in the corner. A double-edged game is not what I was looking for here.
Yeah. I think I at least made it a little less one-sided here, which was good.
That was awesome.
This was so really tricky, though. I was expecting this move, and then I saw too. Okay, so I anticipated this. I figured if I do this, your next move is here, and then after I capture, you get the rook.
Yeah,
This
actually,
is what
that's better than what I saw. You're right.
happened.
Nicely spotted.
Well, I mean, I noticed you didn't do this, because I think you ended up right. So I captured because I knew that otherwise my was gonna die.
I
But
got
ultimately,
greedy
had the
here and
move
tried to
here.
trap your rook, and it worked out.
Yeah, see, you moved here. I was fully expecting you to just pull the Tolkien back, like I did before, and then you moved here, and I was like, oh. Okay, cool. Maybe I can still save my and I could, but
I
at what cost?
had a lucky tactic.
Yeah. Let's see, what's the next move? I wrote down 47 as like a potential. Maybe I had a better response here. I think I was considering just capturing the token here.
Oh, that's clever. Yeah.
I mean, the reason I didn't is because you have this now, and this
Sure.
is pretty yikes for me. I have to move the rook somewhere, and then you
Yeah.
can come over here.
Yeah,
And
it's super tactical for sure.
this is very scary.
Yeah. This makes me think a lot, 'cause I'm sure there's so if I surrender the file, my bishop's still hanging.
That's true, I guess. Well, so I could move the rook back here, you think?
Maybe.
But then
Yeah.
you can just do that. I mean, I guess I could come here, but I think in this position, you're better.
Maybe, but maybe before taking the knight, you could throw in something like this.
Oh, yeah.
Although now
Kind of.
maybe I have a chance to like block the rook, so maybe I don't know. Like, this is tactical for sure.
Yeah, I think. I mean, you don't have to take this knight here. It's just my
Oh,
first thought
sure.
is just
Yeah, in
that.
fact, yeah, I might. I'm trying to think what else. Taking pieces is so tempting because I, as a chess player, you like to take the things.
Yes.
But
Yeah.
yeah, you get a counterattack no matter what I take.
Yeah. You can pull back. I don't really have a lot of options
Oh,
here.
all right. Yeah, no, that's right.
So, I mean, I'll probably do this first. So I get a silver.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. So maybe I don't take the lance either, because like if I'm losing pieces and my castle degrades, yeah, I wonder. Oh, sorry, backing up a little bit
Yeah,
more.
sure. Right.
I wonder if I have something super forceful here somehow. Like, can I just invade and then threaten to invade here and promote or something? Or I guess I'm still threatening that too.
I would be less nervous about this, I think, because now I can do this.
Oh, sorry, I forgot I still have this shot though.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's true. So that wouldn't really matter.
Yeah, I'm trying to like bully your rook around a little bit. So this is
It was
check.
working. Oh yeah, and that loses the rook the same way.
Yeah.
I could hug the king even though this is a bad idea, generally.
Yeah, and maybe at this point I say mission accomplished, and then, yeah, like you can drop the pawn, but
Or
I can drop
promote.
mine and.
Oh yeah, you could actually, yeah, pulling back the silver first would be good, and then yeah, there's
Yeah.
nothing I can really do.
Yeah, at this point, I'm the only player with an attack, so I'm content with this. Yeah.
I guess I could make a castle here, but this still seems better, though, I think, than ultimately what happened, which was I just
Yeah, well, I think
went
there's a
for
third
trades.
possibility. So I was able to get a tempo on your rook because it advanced all the way up as far as it did. Maybe this might be playable. It's tricky though. I think
Moving up
it's.
one.
Yeah, I think this is similar to the game. It's just I don't get the pawn drop. Interesting. I forgot about that. Yeah, I guess maybe knight takes? I don't know.
I guess there is the knight. Oh. I always forget about the knights, actually. This is a big weakness I have, I think.
Well, usually moving the knights is really dangerous, but you have a really dangerous and
Right.
unusual position here. So maybe there's some something or other
This
here.
actually doesn't look quite as bad as the other one. You do have the dragon, but
Yeah.
This looks livable for me because now I can kind of do what I was planning to do. I think this is okay. I'm down a little bit of material, but that's like
Well,
not
to
as
help
big a
fix the
deal.
material thing, take the silver, right?
Oh yeah, that's right. Or I keep jumping the dragon over here, but instead you could just
I think it's yeah, this looks livable, I think.
What was the yeah, because what was the move he played was that. So
Yeah, and then we got lured down a series of tactics. Each one of them, you made some decisions, and then yeah, it didn't quite work out.
yeah, so I think, yeah, you're right. I actually, that probably was the best move because I was afraid of that one, but I've got the knight there.
Yeah. I could be missing some tactics there somewhere, and there might be some reason that that's also complicated, but
Maybe.
yeah, even after bringing the rook up, I don't think you're forced to exchange the generals like you exchanged there either.
Here?
Yeah. I think you could run away. Or, sorry, I don't know if that shows up, but I think you could run away here.
It does. Whatever you did, it works. I
Yeah.
think we can both click on the board and see what the other person is doing.
Oh, cool.
So I can run here.
Yeah, it's spooky, I'll give you that, but I think it's livable.
I think I definitely prefer
Yeah.
this move, I think. That feels like the
Yeah,
best
I would
one.
prefer this.
Or maybe capturing the Tolkien. Either way, I
Oh
shouldn't have
yeah.
left the Tolkien there. That was probably like my downfall was leaving that alone.
Yeah, once
That
more
was
pieces
definitely the
started
beginning.
exchanging, unfortunately in chess, exchanging pieces makes things seem simpler, and in shogi, not so much.
Right, it actually makes things so much worse depending on your position.
Yeah.
Piece exchange is like one of the craziest things to get used to. I'm always so nervous about any piece exchange thing. And then I think this was all probably like the best I could do here.
Yeah,
I
I
thought
think.
maybe what did I play here? Was this? I think I maybe should have done this earlier.
Let me think.
What would be your attack here? Because I think what was your move when I played this? Was that? So if I
Yeah,
had
I
played.
admit, like, so I'm learning this as I go here a bit, because, usually in Shogi Wars, I just take a lot of pieces and then I'm able to promote all my pawns and win. But yeah, that's a tempting move. I think, yeah, it gives you this a possibility to block the diagonal and develop your bishop, though. So maybe I need something more forceful. I wonder, do I have time for something crazy like this? It takes the square so your pieces can't use that square, but then also,
Yeah,
like, your
actually
silver's
probably
pinned.
better with there, maybe.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, the silver's pinned at the moment, but yeah, if I were to move the token sideways, you'd take it.
Yeah, it
And
kind of gets my general away from where it needs to be.
I wonder.
We can play through this if you.
Yeah, let me think. This is a really hard next move here.
I felt like once I got the king over, I was a little bit more secure, even though I did end up like ultimately losing. I felt like I could at least turtle for a while.
Yeah, no, I was surprised. That was really resilient there.
Thank you.
Okay, can I get away with this, I wonder?
So here.
'Cause yeah, if this works, it's epic. It's just a question of does it work? Let's see. How many pieces can I sacrifice here? Oh, do we have? I
Yeah, we can
wonder, is
always
there
go
something
back.
like this here? So I've split up the castle, and then can I do something like that? And then something like this. So I have a choice between like a bishop drop, or I could do a knight. No, the knight drop doesn't do anything. But yeah, this might be good enough. Let's see. Oh, and then this is a check. So I think you'd actually have to go the other way or something. I think the king might need to dodge into here because this mates.
Well, I can't move the other way because of the bishop. This move is forced. This is my only move.
Oh, I'm sorry, from like here though.
Oh, you mean, oh, from there to here?
Yeah. It looks terrible. Oh, yeah.
That actually might. You're no, you're right, I
I
think.
guess it might not be a mate, but it might be impossible to defend anyway. Oh wait, now I've got this too. Wow. 'Cause I got a gold general.
This loses.
Dang.
Yeah, once you had the gold, it was like kind of over, I
Oh
think.
yeah. I guess it's kind of like that bear in the hole, the Onaguma Castle, that the gold just really holds that together.
It does, yeah. That was kind of my in the, you know, in the actual game. I was like here.
Yeah.
I just really didn't want to do that, but I didn't see like another way
Oh
forward here.
yeah. No, I
I mean, I
think.
guess I could have played that.
Interesting. Oh right, so yeah, when I dropped the pawn, this is one thing I was thinking about. I really wanted to win the bishop for free, but I'm not getting it for free. So the next best thing is I could try to exchange my pawns for pieces.
I was thinking this move.
Yeah. Oh, that makes a lot of sense because a knight's not going to help you defend if I give you a knight. Yeah.
Right. I mean, I could put it in your way, but it's not going to be doing much.
Right.
I guess, yeah, this was the last move I was thinking of, was the 71, but.
Yeah,
Yeah, I think the game was basically over already at this point.
at this point, unfortunately, I'm the only player attacking, 'cause yeah.
Oh yeah, I mean, like even if I'm able to fend off all your attacks, there's nothing for me to counter with.
Yeah, at this point, I've actually managed to defend most of my pieces. Like yeah, I brought the gold up so the golds defend and the silver defends and the rooks defend the bishop and everything's all protected somehow.
Yeah, so I think those were the two moves. Was letting that pawn go was a bad idea. This was a bad call. And then that other one was a bad call.
Yeah.
And two bad calls is enough versus Ichidan.
Yeah, it's really situational. So like throughout the game, when I was in doubt of what to do, I mean, sure, I would try to move the rook around a little and make some threats, but when in doubt, I would just continue making my castle. And so
Yeah.
like even if I'm not sure how my attack is going to work, I'm pretty sure what castle I'm building. So timing wise, it looked like a little bit earlier, yeah, you built an attack and started attacking, even though we weren't a lot was up in the air. And I don't know, for me, I just like to complete the castle or build it out a little bit further than my opponents built theirs.
Oh, for sure. I was thinking, let's see, where did I kind of start attacking was right around here.
Yeah. Oh yeah, the rook move,
Which,
I guess, initiates it.
yeah, and I should have done something like that. Just got the king.
Yeah, you
And I
need
could
to.
have, I actually could have just pushed the silver out of the way too.
Oh yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, somehow secure the king and yeah, go
I
ahead.
didn't want to put the king in the line of the bishop, was my main hesitation with this, but.
That makes sense. Yeah. Oh yeah, that's why I opened this diagonal. I'm like, well, okay, he stopped me from attacking on the side of the board, so I might as well try to like at least give my bishop somewhere to go and make some vague threats here that maybe someday it'll work out. But also give the opponent something to think about.
Yeah, this might have also been a good move to stop that. Although, because your silver's there already, you could just do it anyway.
Well, yeah, and this, I guess this does also get situational because then you have time for stuff like this. And
Yeah, but the it
yeah.
doesn't matter because the line is open.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you're right. Yeah. Yeah, in some lines you're able to completely stop my pawn advance, but here a complete stop of that's not really feasible. I guess at some point, like the head of my bishop maybe could be a target, but it's not so easy.
No, yeah. Well, thanks for the games. Is it Todovsky or Toad of Sky?
I think it's the former. I just use it in writing, but yeah. Yeah, it's good
Nice.
fun. Yeah, these teaching ladder games, you always get to learn something new each time. Like this time, I was trying to build with my rook out on the right. There's the shape that I think Shogi Harbor is calling Yagura Destroyer, where you just stick the rook on this file and try to like activate the bishop before the opponent has time to do anything.
I see.
And I don't know everything about it, but I wanted to try it out, and it seems like it did okay this time.
Yeah, I didn't really complete the Yagura, so if that's an incomplete Yagura and it gets destroyed, it's even worse.
Yeah. Yeah, these ladder games are always fun. It's so I'm
Yes.
sure we'll see each other again sometime.
Yeah, I'd definitely like to play again another time. So,
Cool.
thanks for the game and thanks for the recap after.
Yeah, likewise. Yeah, it's good having this discussion. It gives me a lot to think about.
Thanks.
Cool.
And then, yeah, if you ever want to play chess, I'd be down for a couple games of chess. By last time, I signed into, actually, I could check now. I don't know what my rating is on chess.com. I think it was 1700, 1800.
Oh, fun. Yeah.
I'm playing chess forever. My like actual rating though is still at like 700 because I haven't played an official tournament game since I was like 10 or
Yeah,
something.
that's the way to do it. I've had some friends like go to major tournaments with the rating around 1,000 and they haven't played in forever and then they like win some prize. It's hard to do
Yeah,
that because everybody
I need
tries to do
to.
that.
Yeah, now it's yeah. If everyone is doing the same thing, you my friend works at the Chess Emporium, which is like a local chess area.
Oh, fun.
Or I don't know if it's international. I've only ever seen them here in Arizona, but I need to ask him. He said they do like team tournaments, and he's like, "Yeah, you can be our sandbag."
Nice. That's a great way to learn.
For the enemy.
That makes sense.
But yeah, cool. That's fun playing together. I'll see you around.
All right, see ya. Have a good night.
You too. Bye.
Bye. All right. I think I figured out the discolored call. So yeah, one heck of a game here. Yeah, each time that there's an attack, you can either defend or counterattack as circumstances warrant. And yeah, I was having to figure out some of this as I went. I mean, I'm sure there's something for me to learn about fourth file rook here and Wouldn't surprise me if a bishop exchange is somehow theoretical in some way. It's probably a year or two ago I played something here or on Shogi Wars that resulted in a bishop exchange. But here my opponent wanted to play the fortress, and so they blocked the diagonal and they gave me one tempo, but I quickly gave up the tempo because I didn't know what I was doing. And yeah, a lot of things changed quite a few times here, but yeah, as I was shuffling around my pieces trying to make vague threats, this showed up. And I think I spent at least 30 seconds thinking here, like, do I defend it? Do I counterattack on the file? And yeah, this counterattack is the way to go. But I thought it was going to be my move in this position. And if it's my move, then I can take the silver and this is just winning, but it's not my move. And this could have been an entire game in itself, and it's potentially complicated. I mean, maybe it's a lot easier than I'm pretending it is. Maybe. Is this even playable here? I don't know. Because is this playable here? Maybe. We'll leave that to the engines or the viewers to figure out. So, yeah, maybe we played this the best we could here. Maybe I was completely off base suggesting that. I don't know. Anyway, yeah. Yeah, they counterattack in the center and they cut off my rook. I insisted, and there we go. And there we go, and yep, they keep attacking. And this by itself wasn't decisive, but exchanging generals, melting away the castle, might have been a bit much. But yeah, things got really sharp. And somehow I was the only one with attacking pieces when the dust cleared. Yeah, this gold drop was pretty weird. Maybe they are supposed to take it. I don't think so. Well, hang on. Hang on. During the game, I was thinking this is not such a great idea. But now that we're looking at the game afterward, maybe there's something here. Yeah. So maybe, yeah, okay. Fun times. Anyway, we got a checkmate. It looked really cool. And we both learned a lot. So what more could you ask for? Thanks for watching.